I'm like a half hour away from like the biggest call of my life. I swear.
I ended the last episode on this clip, and boy, let me tell you, buckle up, we're going for a ride because there is a lot to explain, okay? As 52 weeks comes to a close, I need to explain to you two things before we get to the meat and potatoes. One, what the heck this call actually is, and two, what this call affects.
What's up, bro?
There's a lot more going on here than you think.
Well, are you just talking about Michael B. Jordan, or?
That right there is what you'd call a man in love. So in love, in fact, that for the first time in his life, he had talked about getting married to a girl. But surely not until October, right? Over the past 4 months, I had worked with a client down in Phoenix, Arizona, doing photo and video work, and between work, Chantel, and trying to get 52 weeks out, I was busy. My schedule equals slammered.
A lot of things happen when you're busy and in love, and time starts sliding.
You watch your girl become comfortable with your parents, you start talking openly about the future, and you start to realize that you'd do anything to stay with this girl. Which is why this call held a lot more weight than I ever could have expected.
If this framing is right, might as well take the time to kind of explain what the heck is going on. I just got an offer from a company in Phoenix. So I would literally have to like uproot everything from Utah, probably get married faster than I expected, and move to Arizona.
I thought you were a goner.
Extra backstory, Shannon and I got this ridiculous spiritual experience that was like, yeah, we gotta get married to each other. But it was on a random Tuesday. That didn't make any sense until the next day when we got the call, and yeah, things got real.
Who would have thought Arizona?
I built my dream home with my bare freaking hands, and I was gonna have to leave it after just 4 months of living there.
Couple years in Arizona, and then we can, you know, decide if we like it, or if we wanna raise a family there, or if we wanna go to the moon. Yeah.
But I was surprised to find that I didn't care. I don't know if I did my time as a single man well or and was ready to move on to the next thing or what. All I knew is that I could go build more dream homes with Chantel. The clip at the start of this video was me 2 seconds before accepting that job. So, Arizona, starting in April. And I wasn't about to leave without the girl.
Love you.
I love you. I'm excited to marry you.
It's real. Whoa.
So let me introduce you to something I'd been working on for quite some time. What is Operation BAWAA? It's an acronym, and if you can guess what it is in the comments, I'll be really impressed. After I started dating Chantel, I recorded thoughts in front of a camera after every important event in our relationship. And stuck them all in a folder called Operation
BAWAA.
Around this time, Chantel stated, "I don't think we have enough photos or videos of us." And I kept my mouth shut because I was sitting on a freaking gold mine. So I took a couple days and made a video to propose with. And knowing that Chantel wanted to be surprised, saw the perfect opportunity to make things happen. I was supposed to start work down in Arizona on the 1st of April and was scheduled to fly out in mid-March to find housing. Unfortunately, that trip was canceled due to coronavirus, but Chantel didn't know that, so.
Good morning. I'm flying out to Arizona today.
Okay, bye. You safe.
See you soon.
Don't breathe people's air.
See you too, safe.
Here's the thing. I didn't actually go to Arizona. In fact,
Chris came to pick me up.
I picked him up from Arizona.
It's so fast there. So fast that we're not even on a plane at all. So we have exactly one full day to figure out how the heck to surprise her.
Do you remember this place? Well, it's a...
Oh, shit! Oh.
Anyways, well, this is an old theater that my dad had access to, complete with trapdoors, old film lying around, and a spotlight. Since I was out of town, Chantel's good friend Jocelyn had managed to convince her to go eat at this cool new underground restaurant on Main Street. So we had a couple hours to get everything set up, all while tracking Jocelyn through the Find My Friends app.
This is sick.
Dude.
This is so cool. I'd be more about like showing it on the cement.
I'm the best hot spot.
I'm the best spot that it would be.
Yeah, I want that.
I don't know.
It's looking good.
I'll have 6 minutes of butterflies back there, and then it'll be, just go get it done.
Are we keeping this light here then?
No, it's a little.
Yeah, that's so she knows where to sit.
It's a magnet. Genius.
So after one last text from Jocelyn and one false alarm, everything was in place for me to ask my dream girl to marry me.
False alarm, false alarm. Take two.
So freaky.
I've ever told anyone that I love them.